everyone, Michelle Fix It. We are leaving Georgetown and we are going to go to Crazy Cat Lady's house, but we are going to stop for gas first. So you guys will have a pause session at some point. But you guys can enjoy the drive and please subscribe. And enjoy the music too. But I don't have anything to rhyme with music just yet. So I will say something. Just you take me on that bet. See, right. Also have to check our transmission fluid. So I'm going to put gas in the truck and then I will come back and you guys can maybe sort of almost watch me check my transmission fluid. Okay. All right. You guys hang out with Crazy Cat Lady. She's not going to meow or bite you. Maybe like there'll be interesting people. I don't know. Oh, you guys want to do your zoomy zoomy stuff. Okay. Well, zoomy zoomy out there. There you go. Lots of perspective. I give you music. I do this so that way you guys can sort of see what I'm doing. Here's some music. Age.
Georgia Cat ain't playing no games. Paint the town red, right here.
This is Amanda Seals. Check out my daily podcast, The Amanda Seals Show, where me...
Nope.
Everything happens.
Now we go. Ka-chook. Ka-chook. never said I was the best parallel parker ever, because I'm not. I hate parallel parking. Can't stand it. Can't stand it. I liked it better when the neighborhood didn't have as many people. Because now I have to, like, worry about parking. And worrying about parking is no fun. Is not fun. Is not fun at all. Nope. Alright, let me consolidate my drinks. Non-alcoholic beverages, everyone. I don't really drink, like, at all. So I have Popeye sweet tea. I have a mix of a little Coke and a little tea. Coca-Cola. And... now I need to take a bath. I was going to say I need to put lotion on my face. You guys are accountability for putting lotion on my face. For some reason, like, teenagers are talking about not having the energy to brush their teeth for a month and a half. And I think that that is a mommy issue. I think that, like, mommies should be reminding their children, no matter how old, to brush their teeth. Just random Michelle advice. You know, because I'm learning so much stuff from the teenagers that will soon be adults. So if you need a mommy, I don't care if you are whatever you are. I will care about you. I will not try to indoctrinate you into a religion. I have my own. If you have one, great. If you don't have one, great. I hope you believe in something for morality's sake. Not mortality's sake, morality's sake. And it's not that I don't care, as in, I don't care. It's that you could label me, if you so choose, to label me as pan or bi or heterosexual or whatever. Those are things that are, they're personal things, and they're, like, so out there right now, and that's cool. But me personally, I don't talk about my stuff, but I mean, I will talk about my stuff, and I guess I'm kind of talking about my stuff right now because it's a big hot topic. And just because you don't, like, if you're a cis, like, that's the big thing I keep hearing about. Just because you're a cis person, doesn't mean that you are automatically anti whatever orientation. Because anyone looking at me would automatically assume that I am as straight as they can be, and that's it. But I've said it before, I have no embarrassment, no shame, no whatevers. My dad knows, my husband knows. And if someone asked me for one, I would be like, it's none of your business. But if I cared to answer other than it's none of your business, I would tell them that they can identify me whatever way they want to. You just can't label me as just homosexual because clearly I have babies and stuff like that. But there is beauty and grace and niceties with the female form. And if I lose people in my audience because of that, that's cool. You can be biased and you can be angry. Because I was so non-biased, I at one point was married to an open atheist. And another point, I was married to an open pagan. And I've been a staunch Catholic, even though a bad one, since the cradle. So, you know, keep your isms to yourself. And don't walk around acting like you are the bestest thing in the whole entire world when you've been an ism person probably since the cradle. And I saw a video that rather upset me, where a child was talking about how both them and their parental unit were mentally ill, and so it was okay for everything to be all messed up because they didn't have the energy to do corrections on that. And sometimes you had to put your big girl panties on or your big boy boxers on and be an adult and do things that you have to do to make sure that your children, emphasis on children, are taken care of. Because if you want that responsibility because of another person, and then you gain that responsibility, and then you push the other person away, and then they leave, and they were the responsible adult, or just the adult, the breadwinner, and the adult, and you don't know what you're doing, and then you get depressed, and you throw your hands up in the air, and you mess it up so badly that hospitalizations take place for numerous different things, ranging from mental health issues to eating disorders to almost not being around for your child, you totally messed up the assignment. And then it becomes very frustrating that the thing that you used to pride yourself on saying all the time is, if at first you don't succeed, failure is your lifestyle. That's that whole cat throwing stones thing. You throw a bunch of stones, and then whenever you're the one with the glass house, like, it gets busted into constantly. Don't be that person. Just don't. If you're going to be responsible enough to have children, whether you wanted them or not, again, not talking about any specific person, grow up, put your big girl panties on, put your big boy boxers on, or your big girl boxers on, or your big boy panties on, it doesn't matter to me, and do what you're supposed to do. That is all. I'm a grumpy person, but I'm not really. I'm happy and angry. And when things aren't taken care of, it makes me angry. Bye.